Glenis Wilmot, Labour member for the East Midlands, leader of the Labour group. I mean, this is quite disturbing news, isn't it, that night shift work seems to be a major cause, potentially, of breast cancer.
It's very disturbing. We've known for some time that shift work can cause cardiovascular disease and other diseases. But, you know, this is significant evidence now. And we've got a lot of shift workers in the UK, a lot of women shift workers, and they need to be protected. We also knew that it had an impact on pregnant women, which is why pregnant women have the choice not to work night shift. But this is another thing, breast cancer. Who would have thought working night shift would cause people to have breast cancer?
So is there a role for the EU in this? I mean, presumably the EU tends to pass labour law all at once. I mean, are you taking this up?
Yes, I intend to write to the Commissioner and ask to look at the evidence at other, in other member states. I know there's a study being done at the moment in the UK. The Health and Safety Executive are doing a study, but it won't be available until 2011. I think we need some action before that, and we need to know exactly what's happening across Europe with this disease.
Presumably, since Denmark has already paid out to some 40 women, they obviously have done the research and are convinced by the evidence, so sharing best practice might be an option here.
Yes, it's a very good idea to share best practice, but I still would like to see the evidence across all member states. If it affects Denmark, it's going to affect women everywhere, and we need to make sure that we protect women as far as we can do.
Would you like to see perhaps an end to night shift working for women altogether? Because obviously they do suffer from it more than men do, although it's an unpleasant job to have to do, the graveyard shift as it's known.
Yes, I think this is, we're talking here about continuous night shift work. We're not talking about people who are on a rota. So it's, we have to remember that. There's a difference there. So we're not talking about nursing staff who may do days and then nights. We're talking about people who continuously work night shift. But if the evidence proves that this is a problem, then we need to seriously look at this, because what we don't want to do is endanger people's lives.
What about the East Midlands, your own constituency? Do you believe that there are a lot of women working night shifts there?
Yes, there are a lot of women working night shifts in all sorts of industries, and women have to work night shifts quite often because of childcare arrangements. They go to work at night, they get up in the morning, take the kids to school, and that's how they have to work. So it does disproportionately affect women in many instances.
Now, of course, you've been picking up the case of Rachel Bennett from your area, who was annoyed that the time limit for cervical smear testing was raised to 25 in England, but not in Wales, Scotland or Northern Ireland, where it remains 20. And she's actually suffered from this and is only 22 now. I mean, this is another cause you'll believe in.
Yes, this is about cervical cancer screening. And Rachel was only 21 when she was diagnosed with cancer, and she's had three operations. She's still only 22. And this could have been prevented if she'd have been able to access screening. And she was told on a number of occasions that this couldn't possibly be cervical cancer, and it actually was. So what we're saying is if young women want to have screening, they should have it available for young women at the age of 20 and upwards.
And in England as well as Scotland, Northern Ireland and Wales.
Absolutely, it's very, very important. And Rachel went to a reception at Number 10 last Monday in order to lobby ministers to ensure that we get something done on this particular issue. Very, very important. Lives can be saved, because cervical cancer is one form of cancer that actually can be battled and can be cured.